all of a sudden, things looked very odd to me. I looked at my fingers like this, and I could see some fingers and others I couldn't. Am I having a stroke, or what is this? You know, what's going on?
Sue Nguyen was 28 years old with a promising career when the first symptoms appeared. After several trips to the emergency room, she got disturbing news.
The ER doc said, I must tell you, you have a 50% chance of having MS. I just dismissed it. I just said, I don't have time for that. This can't possibly be that. I feel fine.
She moved on with her life and career, but one night at home with her husband, her symptoms erupted.
I was sitting watching the evening news with Jeff, and Jeff has a tendency to like to jiggle his foot. And so I said, Jeff, stop jiggling. He said, I'm not, but you are. And I was going like this. And then it started to go like this. And then it started to go like that. And I was scared to death because I didn't know, and I couldn't stop. It just kept going like that.
Her family doctor confirmed her fears.
She says, I think this is MS. My breath just went out of me. I couldn't breathe, you know? How could this be? You know, what? How can this? My whole life is just before my eyes, and I'm seeing everything is gone.
There was a complete darkness in our lives, a complete depression in our lives.
Her neurologist found lesions on her brain and immediately started treatment for multiple sclerosis. Her condition deteriorated quickly. Within a few months, she was forced to retire on disability.
It was just continuing on with this relentless attack. There was no helpful branch to grab onto. I couldn't slow it down. The tremors started in April of 1996, and by August, I needed forearm crutches to walk.
I was losing her.
Sue joined an MS support group to cope with the disease. She made friends with a woman there who invited her and Jeff to church.
We were very skeptical at first. I mean, me, I was New Age, Buddhism, Hinduism, all that mixed together. Here Jeff is an atheist, so what are we doing sitting in a pew?
I was agreeing only because I thought it will distract her from the pain and the agony of MS.
But they were so nice to us, and we just decided we wanted to go back again. And then we went back every Sunday. It stirred us. We were being stirred. We were being touched by God. I wanted to commit myself to Him.
They met with the pastor to find out more.
He took us through a membership class, and I learned about grace. And so we got up in front of the whole church and said, we believe Jesus Christ is the Son of God. It was life-changing. Life-changing.
As Sue grew spiritually, her health was deteriorating. The doctors were out of options and offered her chemotherapy in an attempt to slow down the disease.
I got so sick. I just said to Jeff, I don't think I can do this anymore. I really want to stop. Within just a few weeks of stopping the chemotherapy, everything intensified. Everything went downhill. That was very difficult time.
One Sunday, her pastor shocked the congregation.
He was standing in the pulpit and said, I'm going to stick my neck out. I've had a vision, and in it, Sue, you are healed. And I didn't believe healing was for today. And yet my face lit up and I smiled.
Sue's doubt didn't stop her pastor, and he met with her and Jeff regularly for Bible study.
He says, the first thing we need to do is go to Hebrews 13:8. Read it out loud. The minute I said, Jesus Christ is the same yesterday and today and forever, I was immediately convicted that I had limited God. I was saying, He doesn't do that. And this word was telling me, oh yeah, He does.
She began reading healing scriptures, and with each visit from their pastor, Sue's faith for healing grew.
I had faith, and I'm saying, oh yeah, yeah, He's gonna do it. I go to bed this one night, and a wave of doubt. Who do you think you are? MS is incurable. You're fooling yourself. You're not worthy. On and on. and I was crushed. All my faith, it seemed, went right out the window. And I heard in my heart, "You're sinking in a sea of doubt." And I knew it was the Lord. I knew it was His voice.
Sue went downstairs and read her Bible.
And all of a sudden, I felt a sensation that I had not felt before. I had felt little, maybe tiny touches, nothing like this. It was like oil was being poured on my head from the inside and was slowly diffusing down through everything, out to the fingertips, down to the toes, everything. And I knew that as it was happening, it was Jesus, and He was healing me. Everything wrong set right, just right down through my body. And I knew I was healed. I woke up the next morning and I felt like I'd been plugged into a supercharger. I mean, I'm like, there's power in me that I have never felt before. And I mean, this is a whole new thing. Oh my goodness, what has happened?
At her next visit to the neurologist, the doctor confirmed her miracle.
He looked in my eyes first, and there was damage in my left eye that was visible with an ophthalmoscope. And it was gone. And he said, "This is God." He tested my whole body, did all the usual neurological tests, and there was no evidence of any neurological problem.
For more than a decade, Sue has been free of MS. She and Jeff have started a ministry using her miracle to share Jesus with others.
What I really want is for others to know Him intimately. I pray that when I speak to them and when I give them my testimony, it makes them hungry and that they want to pursue God. He is just endless, and what He does is endless, and with Him, nothing is impossible.